लेक्चर नंबर 13 द नेक्स्ट कॉम्प्लेक्सेस द ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट्स दे आर एबल टू फॉर्म द कॉम्प्लेक्सेस नाउ एवरी ट्रांजिशन एज वेल एज द इनर ट्रांजिशन मेटल दे हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू फॉर्म कॉम्प्लेक्स नाउ व्हाट इज द रीजन why it is able to form the complex there are the several reasons for the same their ionic radii is small their effective ionic charge is higher hence it is having a high ratio of the ionic charge to the ionic radius next the transition elements and the ions they have got various vacant d orbitals which can accommodate the lone pair of electrons कौन देगा वो लिगेंड्स देगा टू द सेंट्रल मेटल एटम टू फॉर्म द कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड्स दे हैव वेरिएबल ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट्स आफ्टर एक्सेप्टिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम द लिगेंड्स द मेटल आयंस दे अक्वायर अ स्टेबल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ द नियरेस्ट इनर्ट गैस एंड देन इट फॉर्म्स द स्टेबल कॉम्प्लेक्स नेक्स्ट पॉइंट द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स अपॉन द नेचर ऑफ द मेटल आयन द लिगेंड्स एंड द बॉन्डिंग नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट वी कम फॉर एक्सप्लेन द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट्स राइट हैंड साइड में एवरी क्वेश्चन मे बी अ टू मार्क क्वेश्चन एक्सपेक्टेड इन द एग्जाम नाउ व्हेन आई से रिगार्डिंग द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी सो इट मे बी ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स दैट इज डायमैग्नेटिक होता है पैरामैग्नेटिक रहता है फेरोमैग्नेटिक रहता है Now, what is diamagnetic? When I can say the electrons are paired and so they are repelled by the applied field. While, jo paramagnetic rehte hai, the electrons are unpaired and hence they are attracted towards the magnetic field. The substances which are attracted very strongly, they are called to be ferromagnetic in nature. And in fact, ferromagnetism is the extreme form of paramagnetism. Many of the transition metals, they are paramagnetics because they are attracted towards the magnetic field. Now, paramagnetism arises because of what? It is arising because of the presence of the unpaired electron. Each such electron having a magnetic moment associated with the spin angular momentum and the orbital angular momentum. So, for this, the magnetic momentum is determined by the number of unpaired electrons and by it can be solved by you can have it by the formula it is the root of n into n plus 2 bm what is bm it is Bohr magnetism so now 1 bm is equal to eh upon 4 pi m into c what is e it is the charge of the electron h is a Planck constant m is the mass of the electron and c is the velocity of light Now, textbook may, there is a solved example too, and it's very easy to find the angular momentum of the same. So, that is regarding the magnetic property of the transition elements. Next, we go for the alloy formation. You know what is the alloy? The transition metal, they form the large number of alloys. Since the D block elements, they are quite smaller in the atomic size, the number of the atoms of one metal It can substitute the atoms of the other metal in its crystallized. Why? Because their atomic size is similar. Thus, on cooling, a mixture solution of two or more transition metals, smooth solid alloys are formed. And when the alloy contains mercury, it is called as the amalgam. The purpose of making alloys It is also known like, see, we have got various ferrous alloys, chromium, vanadium, tungsten, molybdenum, manganese. They form a large variety of the steel and the stainless steel. The alloys of transition metals with the non-transition metals, it is brass. For example, copper and zinc is blended. Copper and tin, it will form bronze. So, these are having a great industrial importance. So, that I can say regarding the alloys of the transition elements. So, okay, we proceed with the next lecture.